I was 9 years old. How many of you know of Operation Christmas Child? Awesome. So you guys know all about it. When I was 9 years old in an orphanage, the most hopeless place I was in, and at the age of 9, I get this shoebox, an Operation Christmas Child shoebox. A very simple thing like a shoebox. To me, it made the biggest difference. It was like, right then and there, I had hope for the future. I had something. It was as if somebody planted a seed in my heart. I didn't get to hear the gospel presentation or hear about Jesus, but I got to see the love of people. And just like in the skit, a simple thing like a blanket. In my case, it was a shoebox that had cough drops in it. How many of you like cough drops? I thought it was candy at first, so I slammed one and I'm like, ooh, this is good. And then the aftertaste kicked in. I'm like, you know, nope, cough drops didn't work out too good. And just the simplest thing like cough drops, I will never forget that. But I will never forget that gift. I've gotten bigger gifts in America, but I'll tell you, that gift was the coolest gift I ever received. And just the simple shoebox gave me a lot of hope. And even though, I'll be honest, after I received that box, my life didn't get perfect all of a sudden. I wasn't this angel that, you know, I still had the regular struggles of being an orphan. I still, you know, stole and I, you know, drank and I smoked. I tried to do these things to fit in. I still had that hope always. I never lost it. And by the time I was getting close to 13, I had really violent behavior because I guess I didn't fit in, and the only way to get attention from the staff was to do something violent, like break items or to make disturbances, you know. And then at that time, they diagnosed me to be psychotic, and they put me in a facility for 8 months. Meanwhile, I still had that hope, but at the same time, I never dreamt of like being adopted to America, right? This was not even on my agenda. I was just searching for that hope I felt. And while I was in that facility, the mental facility, my youngest sister, Clava, who was living in a different orphanage at the time, she got the privilege and honor to come to America for this program called Journey of Hope. And she stayed with my parents, Doug and Becky, and she stayed for 2 weeks and they prayed about it and decided to adopt her. When they found out that she had a brother and a sister, they were really iffy about it and they prayed about it some more. And God told them, yep, you're getting it done. No options on this one, so I turned out to be the bonus package, I always say. Nothing's gonna be as awesome as Jesus in your life. So ever since that day, I've been like, I've always wanted to help in ministry. I've wanted to be the hands and feet of Christ. It's contagious. I love sharing Christ with somebody who hasn't heard of it and see their face and see their reaction when they actually find that relationship with Christ. So ever since that, I've been involved with Operation Christmas Child like all the time. I got to go to Panama with Operation Christmas Child and hand out OCC boxes. When we went to the islands, they lived in huts. I mean, it was such a culture shock. In the same within miles, you had this rich people and you had the poor people. So our first day we get there and we had gotten there really late the night before and we woke up at 4 a.m. and took a boat to one of the islands. So we're all really tired and groggy, and we had all day of distributing shoeboxes and, you know, doing like activities and doing skits and such for these kids. Towards the end of the day, we're doing a distribution on this one church, and a lot of kids showed up, a lot more than we planned for, and this is our first day, so we're kind of unprepared. And we gave out all the boxes, and it looked like we had enough. It was like perfect, you know, God's got a perfect count. Well, right before we were going to share the gospel, like they were all sitting, we're going to share the gospel again for these kids and do like a countdown. One of the moms walks in with her, with a daughter who's a twin of this other one that had received a box and says, hey, my daughter didn't get a box. Could she get one? And we're like, all of us kind of go, oh no, this is not good. We don't have one. So we all kind of, you know, step back and kind of pray in our minds. We're going like, okay, God shows to us, you know, and we're a little bit nervous because it's our first day. We trusted God, but, you know, you kind of try to control, you know, you kind of get there and you try to be all logistical and like have everything under control. So we're all like, oh no. So we prayed and we said, well, I guess we don't have one. We looked and we didn't have one. We said, can she just share with her sister? And her mom's like, yeah, that's fine. That's no problem, you know. It's still a blessing to be able to share a box. So we do the gospel presentation and some of the kids accept Christ, which is awesome. They do some singing and the countdown. And whenever they open the box, when the twins open their box, you would never believe this. They have two of every single thing in the box. Everything is identical. They had two Barbie dolls. They had two washcloths, two toothbrushes, two hair things. It was two of everything. Like, we didn't do this on purpose. This was God saying, hey, watch this. Somebody packed this in America. I'm taking it to Panama, and I'm going to do this awesome thing right there. Because I know where, because he knows where every box is going. He knows whenever we do the smallest act, whenever we do something, if God is part of it, he's gonna be the one that's gonna be on the other end performing the miracle.